Alright, here we are for round two. We're on the draw. I think this is a pretty easy keep, even though we're obviously missing the Ascendancy. Double carry to it is super strong. Oh. Basic Plains typically means heroic, but our opponent led on Soldier of the Pantheon, which is not really a normal heroic card. It's more of a just regular white aggressive card. Ooh, okay, some kind of sweet white Nykthos deck. That sounds cool. I can't imagine this is a bad matchup for us, because they probably not that fast and doesn't really have a lot of disruption in one color. Although, okay, maybe it's two colors, I don't know. Soldier of the Pantheon plus Ajani's Pride Mate is kind of sweet, actually. Anyway, definitely going to block here. I think the odds of him having Defiant Strike are very low. Spirit Bonds, okay. What are we looking at? Could play Rollicker and Karametra's favorite. We basically just want to dig as deep as we can to get to our ascendancy. So we want to set up to do that as well as possible. I think I like Rollicker favor. Well, that stops us from blocking, which kind of stinks. So maybe we just Dragon Mantle this and then play another Caryatid. We get a mana back the turn we play the favor if we play it on the Rollicker. Actually, I think I like just going Caryatid, play Rollicker, and pass. And that gives us a bunch of mana next turn. And we can basically play all the cards in our hand. Dragon Mantle on Caryatid will actually be kind of sweet. It'll be good at blocking for us. He's going to play another Pride Mate, presumably make a token, which is obviously fine. Ooh, okay, gain a life, so his Pride Mate gets bigger. Fortunately, chosen by Heliod on Caryatid will block one of the Pride Mates. Might even consider trading for that Soldier of the Pantheon. Okay, he's not even gonna give us the choice. Okay, Retraction Helix is definitely useful at some point, I think. Not so great. I like casting Dragon Mantle here because it gives us the opportunity to represent actually killing his guy. I guess we'll go ahead and play the Crusader. So yeah, any ascendancy definitely is lethal. I'm a little bit scared of Mass Calcify as a potential thing that could happen to us. But that would have to be his last card. I think with two God's Willings, I'm pretty okay with using one of them this turn to try and get us closer to an ascendancy. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that. Choose Pro White, Retraction Helix. It's not great. I think we'll bottom it. We can use it to cantrip, but we could also just put it on the bottom and draw a different card instead. Well, the different card we drew was a retraction helix anyway. So, alright, let's go ahead and Karametra's favor up. Alright. Play that. I guess we'll just pass. We actually have a 4/5 carry to available to block with here. So as long as we're not getting mass calcified, I think we're in good shape. Or at least we're not dying anytime soon. We have a lot of chumps available to us. Okay, that's like medium scary, but at least very slow. I think again we'll be definitely fire off a God's Willing here, and probably cycle one of these retraction helixes even, because we do just win if we hit. He's just sending in those. Our guy pro white, see another retraction helix. Yeah, it's still not very good. And then I guess we'll go ahead and cycle. Dragon Mantle, because it's the cheapest. Springleaf Drum really doesn't get us anywhere. Come on. Show us an Ascendancy. Okay, Astronomer does get us somewhere. We have to figure out if we're dead to his attack. We can block all of his ground guys with disposable soldiers. 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. It's 8, 9, 10. So he can't double activate. So he can put us to 1 with an activation, which is not 0. So therefore, I think we just play Meletis Astronomer, pass the turn. We can block all of his guys, go to 1, and then next turn go Helix Astronomer, bounce Dragon Mantle, play Dragon Mantle on Astronomer, which will let us look at 8 cards, including our draw step. So that seems like pretty good odds. We should hold the Springleaf Drum, because if we hit on our last chance, then we'll want to be able to go Ascendancy Drum to untap the Astronomer that's already tapped. Yeah. Okay. Story checks out. And I think that's our plan. I guess he could have like a second Nykthos. Would be the only way we really get got. So he's going to gain a whole mess of life here. Which does mean our combo is going to take a little longer than average to kill, but it doesn't make it any less lethal. Okay, so he's not activating. Must have something else to do. It's a lot of mana. Okay. Interesting. Okay, another soul. We were pretty much already set to go for this turn, or bust anyway. So far, not so good. Start with the Helix there. Alright, Rollicker at least does let us go a little more if we need to. Bounce Dragon Mantle. Cast Dragon Mantle. So, okay, we have to hit on this one. Chosen by Heliod's the best one to cast because it lets us see more card. It lets us see an extra card as compared to casting the Rollicker. If we hit here, we win. If we brick, we lose. Alright, it's got to be this draw step then. There we go. Really came down to the wire, but we were definitely very heavy favorites to hit there. We got to look at 10. We got to look at 1, 2, plus 3 triggers. We got to look at 12 cards that turn. So now we just go ahead and bounce this. Replay it on there. We're going to make infinite guys with haste and make them infinitely large. So that is, as they say, game. I guess I can do the usual things that I tend to do to try and make things go faster, which is float a bunch of red. What really makes it go faster is when you find a second Ascendancy. So then you choose always no here and always yield, because we know we're drawing our whole deck with the just with the Dragon Mantle, so we don't actually have to loot. And that makes just a trigger we don't have to worry about. Also, sometimes your opponents eventually get what's going on and decide to scoop, but like that. So as you see, we're gonna generate infinite mana and infinitely large creatures with the Acheron Crusader and attack for the win. Okay, so boarding against Mono White Devotion. I mean, his interaction is probably like erase, negate, and Banishing Light, so Swan Song's definitely good. God's Willing is definitely not good, and we have to cut one more. It's either Springleaf Drum or Chosen by Heliod. I think those are the worst cards in the deck. It's probably just Springleaf Drum. He has so many guys that I think it's unlikely that we'll actually get to kill him with the regular drum combo, which is drum and two guys and a retraction helix. So I think the drums are less good because of that. All right, let's try it.